the Verdes, father and son, who run this sweet shop. But here they don't sell toffees or chocolate. Here you ask for a quarter of la douce, bisan or chèvre.
Excuse me, what are you making?
We are making samosas now.
Pardon?
Samosas.
Samosas?
Yeah.
Well, what is it made of? Because it looks...
It's, you know, it's potatoes, peas, onions and the spices inside it.
Well, I must say, the finished product, it looks very much like a Cornish pasty.
That's right, that's right.
Very tasty. I suppose a lot of English people are coming
yes,
into these things
now. Yes, a lot of them
now.
Are coming by these.
Yes.
Here.
Now, what about this here? Can you show me how you make that?
This is a sweet which we call jalebi.
Jalebi. What's that made of?
It's a self-raising flour.
But I noticed, excuse me, Mr. Reddy, I noticed that you've got this bottle of water here. What does it says? Indian water.
Yeah, this is a Kevada water. This gives a very special taste in that syrup there.
It's very special. Why must you use Indian water?
No, it's not really Indian water. It's the, you know, the ingredients in the name here.
Kevada water.
Yeah, that's the thing which gives a nice smell.
Flavor.
You know? Yeah.
What happens then now?
This goes in this.
What is that you've got in there?
This is sugar syrup, specially prepared for this job.
Very tasty. Very tasty. Beautiful. I tell you what I'd like to do. May I taste one
yes.
of those, please?
Yes, you can.
Thank you. Because it looks pretty good. Thank you, very good. This does look good. Very sweet, but very tasty. Thank you very much,
That's
Mr. Verdi.
Right.
But it's not only their shops that the Sikhs have brought to Gravesend.
In a former congregational church, they have established their own temple. It's open to anyone, but the custom of covering your head and removing your shoes has to be observed. Charles Revis is the town's community relations officer.
I must say it was very kind of the Verdes sweet shop to give me a turban, and I hope you don't mind.
No, I think it's a sign of respect and love they have for you.
Thank you. Now, could you kindly explain some of the features of this temple?
Well, the picture of Guru Nanak, the founder of the Sikh religion, there, and he lived at the time of Martin Luther. He did not really want to introduce a new religion that was introduced later on. But he was against all formalism in religion.
I see. But what is this temple here?
But you have the canopy,
yes.
then the gold cloth, and the holy book, which is called Adi Granth Sahib, is placed there. And the fly whisk that you have, the two people there.
Who are the two gentlemen?
They are the part of the ministry. Yeah.
They're the priests? Or
the priests. And they are keeping it, not keeping the flies away, but now it's a sign of authority and respect.
Sign of authority
and respect. As we have some of the African leaders.
Yes. Now, what about discrimination in Gravesend towards the Sikh community? Is there any?
Well, there is some. I mean, you can't say that there isn't any. But the Sikhs have been accepted very well by the host community.
I expect they're very, very good workers, aren't they?
Well, that's how they started, because when they first came, the management found that they were very hard-working, very honest, and very diligent.
Also, may I ask, what about the children? There are lots and lots of children in Sikh families, and they go to Western schools, so how do they keep up with the Sikh religion?
Well, the Adi Granth Sahib is written in Gurmukhi, and on Saturday
what
and
is
Sunday,
Gurmukhi?
Gurmukhi is the script peculiar to the Sikh religion. And on Saturdays and Sundays, we have classes in Punjabi and Gurmukhi, so that they can keep in touch with their religion and religious scriptures.
And do the prayers go on here in the temple
yes,
all day?
Yes, start at about 10, go on till about 4. There's a break for lunch, and people go in and out again. So it continues the whole day.
Well, may your religion go on for many hundreds of years. Mr. Revis,
thank you very much.
Thank you very much.